Teaching online is not easy, but it's the management of your class that makes all the difference of whether it runs smoothly or not, whether you had success or maybe not so much success. So in this program, we're going to talk about that very topic, managing an online class, brought to you here from Indiana University. Now, there are many roles or hats for an online instructor. One of the roles or hats that we have in being an online instructor is a social hat. You have to make sure your students feel it's okay to joke, for instance, and to get them into some icebreakers and discussions. We have our technical kind of a hat and managerial kinds of hats that we wear. Our manager oversees the class, and we might have a technical hat that also is involved in terms of passwords and whether the computer's functioning properly. We also are going to have some kind of a pedagogical hats that we wear online, and making sure that students engage and debate and are in role play and all sorts of things. But there are many hats that we wear online, many more than we have in face-to-face environments. We also have time management issues. There are so many factors to consider that you don't want to have everything rushed up against the deadline. You want to plan things out within the class and have your timing of feedbacks for your students, have your announcements for your students so that they know what's coming due, get your books and ordered ahead of time and make them available for your students, as well as the web resources, any sign-up sheets, any sign-ups to be moderators for different weeks or discussion leaders or teams. Get those all ready ahead of time and have them available, those logistics, and lay out that first week of information. I often tell my students the first week of an online class is the hardest, and the last week of a face-to-face class is the hardest. So it just switches things a bit. At the end of a face-to-face class, you got all these exams and all sorts of things to keep track of and turn in. In an online class, there's all sorts of planning components. There's rosters and agenda and syllabi and announcements and emails to collect and all sorts of things that you do online. But there are efficiencies as well. There are things you can do to make that class be more efficient than you ever could imagine by archiving prior work, by saving posts that are long, that are important across classes or across sections and reusing them in some ways, by timing when you're going to go in every week and don't go in every day. Announcements and reminders are also important to keep people on track. Once a week, reporting to your students what you're expecting them to do will get them refocused. Reading what's possible in online and how to manage. Read Faculty Focus. Read EDUCAUSE and all their wonderful reports and EDUCAUSE Quarterly and EDUCAUSE Review and their journals. Read from different universities like the University of Maryland, Wisconsin, Penn State, and Idaho, specialize in online environments. Delegate to a grad assistant or maybe a student who comes back from a previous semester. Delegate down to him or her to help you organize and give feedback within the classroom structure or to find new resources. Find your support services on your campus or in your institution or organization and find out what they can provide to help you teach. Coordinate your rosters a bit. Make them available for your students so they know who's in the class. Make a distribution list of names and emails available. Have a job aid or help system for uploading and downloading files and anything else that students might need to use. Update your resources as the semester progresses. When you read something in the New York Times that's important or in a journal or magazine, the Chronicle of Higher Education, embed that in your class somewhere. Update your resources with new reports from the federal government or from other countries around the world. Have your grading strategies explicit where possible so the students know what your expectations are. You might use some grading strategies that are a little different than face-to-face classes where you might involve more peer evaluation or other kinds of things. And don't grade every day. We'll get back to that in the section on grading in a later program. Think about the challenges that you're going to have in managing the class. In Indiana, where I teach, we have a challenge often in rural southern Indiana of access to the internet. So I tell students to use the library resources that exist, use the school resources that exist. So They can determine if they have adequate access to technology in their homes, whether they're in Maine, whether they're in Japan, Korea, or Africa. Find out if they have that by having an assignment due early, within the first 3 weeks. They can test their passwords. And then create a schedule and stick to it. Have a plan that students know you're going to be going by. Have a schedule that they know you're going to be going by a particular schedule. Organize when you're going in, maybe Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. Cut and paste in content that you might reuse later on. You might find some really unique resources online one semester and reuse them another semester. You might give specific feedback to one student and have the same question come up another semester or later on in the same semester. You can cut and paste and reuse it. When you're managing your class, use a conversational tone. Use their first names where possible. Be personable where possible, so students feel as though there's an instructor who cares. Share stuff that you find. Share the resources that you find, both with your students as well as with colleagues who might be teaching the same class, and you might benefit from things that they share. If students seem to be off task or having troubles, maybe you have office hours of some kind. Maybe you share with them times in which you might be available online for them to directly contact you, maybe even give them your phone number. But when questions arise, be there for your students. You also might bring in guests for your class. Experts might come in for chats. Weekly webinars you might have, and you might archive these for your students. You might have a roster distribution list that's made available for everyone, so everyone can maybe see a picture with the person's name. Maybe have people post a picture in a profile. During the week, you might have emails that summarize or weave together what's going on, or recap events, or address particular problems. Have one or two summary emails each week. That's very beneficial for your students. And use, you know, full communication where everyone reads that email as opposed to directed to one student if it is applicable to everyone. And if that's the case, ask permission of a student who's asked the question if you can respond to the whole class. That will create some economies of scale. Coordinate your tasks within the class. Have maybe other instructors who teach the same class share contents with you. You share with them. You are, in effect, creating some economies of scale by having instructors across different sections, maybe even different parts of the world, share and create. Again, have one assignment due early so you get in the swing of things. Students know what to expect and they get feedback from you. They understand where you're coming from in your grading system, so they're not kind of just wandering around wondering what's happening. You know, assign roles for students, task structures for students, maybe devil's advocate every week, maybe a summarizer or a optimist, a pessimist, but assign and coordinate roles. And if someone's off task, bring them back into the classroom setting through a casual email directed to them, not to the entire class. If you need to, even perhaps call them if they're not participating at all. But disruptive students, don't make fun of in front of the whole class. Bring them to the side. You know, I wish you great luck in managing your online class. It's not easy to do, given the roles that you have to play in an online class or a forum. Managing a class is one of the most difficult things that you have to do. You have to wear that social hat sometimes, getting people engaged. You have to wear that pedagogical hat to get, you know, people excited, challenged, and so forth. Managing so that students are on task, not floundering around within the class. You know, you have to create a timeline and you stick to it. You model what you're expecting of your students to do. And then you, in fact, provide that kind of overarching framework so procrastinating students that you might have in a class find that they're not going to succeed if they do, in fact, procrastinate. So being that person that's part concierge, that might be part orchestra conductor, that might be part police person, there are many roles that we play online, and they all go together, which makes it difficult. But at the same time, anything that's difficult also is sort of fun and challenging and unique. You have an opportunity to be a little different in an online class than you would in a normal class face-to-face. Good luck to you. Wishing you well here from Bloomington, Indiana.